We have come here because we are the first one since independence to sit outside Nairobi, and this is in Article 126 of the Constitution of Kenya. So we are within the Constitution. And we have come here, the two leaders have explained, because we are the guardian angels of devolution, and we want to come and interact, be able to understand some of the issues that affect counties.
On behalf of the county government of Uasin Gishu, to welcome you to Uasin Gishu County, to Uasin Gishu County headquarters, and to the very first Senate sitting outside Nairobi, we as a county are indeed very grateful. I am so lucky to use this first Senate sitting session as a session for capacity building, for my staff, for them to understand how the Senate works, how the committee works. And in this process of capacity building, Mr. Speaker, I asked the team led by Senator for Isiolo, when they came, that we would also like to be among the counties appearing before the Public Accounts and Investment Committee to also answer audit queries of the financial year 2014-15. As a county, since I'm a governor who is in the second term, so those are my queries. And the people who made me go and answer those questions will be here. Fortunately, this time it will not be me. I will be also co-chairing with the Senate committee, passing the questions to the relevant staff so that we can build their capacity in terms of ensuring we use resources well and we also keep good records.
We have come to be part of the team that solves problems. And we want as many problems as possible to be brought to us. That's why we have petitions about mining, we have petitions and the inquiry about maize, we have issues that deal with roads. We are tomorrow, myself and Senator Orengo will lead the team that goes to MTRH. And so we want as much as possible multinational petitions from Nandi, So as much as possible, we want to get as many problems as possible.
We want to support the government in making sure that government has resources to either pay debts or give us money for development. We are asking the Senate to make sure that the money that was meant for counties is not reduced. Let the Treasury look for money in all other votes, but then it wants the money for counties. Really, they should not touch that. I always say, even if we are to rank counties from number 1 to 47, even the county perceived to be not performing at number 47, there are things they will have done. There is no way national government would ever do them, even if we give them 100 years. So we are really seeking as county governments your intervention to ensure that even as we pay these other taxes, the money for counties is really preserved. And I always insist that when we are given the money, we must account for it. Mr. Speaker, this county has a record of attending all the Senate invitations of the Public Accounts and Investment Committee. Because we believe that if you are given resources, you must allow another agency to exercise oversight to make the necessary correction.
It's just a conversation. And there is a conversation, you know, clarify what is not clear, blah, blah, blah. And you go, and the media was also the one that was spoiling this business of grilling, being quizzed, summoned, you know. Those are things that, you know, scare. You get there and already there's tension. We don't want that tension. We want to work together. We want to work for the common mwananchi.
Governor, the visit here is supposed to allay the fears and those doomsayers, those people who are still in Egypt, that one day you can change the tide of devolution. The assurance must be made here that we will fight them whatever it takes.
As a county government, we've also aligned our programs to the national government agenda of housing, universal healthcare, manufacturing, and food security. We, as a county, in housing, we had already started in our first term of devolution the process of rejuvenating some of our old estates. And therefore, the national government agenda of affordable housing sits in very well with our plan of upgrading sheltered housing in this town. Secondly, Mr. Speaker, in terms of food security, in this financial year, in order to support manufacturing, through the Department of Cooperatives, we've established a Cooperatives and Enterprise Development Fund. And as we speak today, we have three cooperatives who have already applied for loans to set up their own milling plants and therefore help us sort out the mess we are in terms of maize.
On behalf of Senate, we are happy and we are enjoying your hospitality, and we are going to do our level best to make sure that we protect